Good afternoon, Ms. Wright. My name is Tim Carter, and I was submitting to you my 3 to 5 minute YouTube video on the reasons why I believe I should be the next Argyle High School principal. Yes, for a brief summary of my educational experience, I've been in education for 23 years. 13 of those years, I was at Lubbock Independent School District as a teacher and coach. The last basically 9 years, I have been at Friendship Independent School District, which is a neighboring community to Lubbock, as an assistant principal at both the middle school for a year and the last 8 years at Friendship High School. In 2005-2007, I was enrolled in Wayland Baptist University's graduate school program. I sought my master's degree in education administration, graduated from there in May of 2007 with a 4.0 grade point average, very proud of that, and was able to start working immediately in educational administration. Got that opportunity, like I said, out of Friendship High School. One of the things that drew me to Argyle was the similarity between Friendship and Argyle, and what I noticed immediately was your academic prowess, your athletic success, and your areas of fine arts that you guys have been very, very successful. Those mirror what we do at Friendship Independent School District and Friendship High School specifically. And I think our concept is that we want to get kids dialed in, plugged in, motivated, to be the best that they can be, whether it be on the band practice field, whether it be on the football field or the court, or whether it be in ag or any other co-curricular sport or endeavor that we do. We want our kids to be the best at everything that they do, much like you guys have that concept at Argyle, and that's very clear and evident when you look at your history and your success. Additionally, I think the similarities between our TAPRs are very, very close. You guys are doing better in a few areas than we are, but both schools are always in the top 15 or 20 of their state comparison groups, always number one or number two in their region. That's what we are at Friendship anyway. In the area of phase-in, you guys in English and math, you're 15, 17 points higher, 17 in English, 15 in math. Science and social studies, you're at 99%, 21 and 23 points higher in the science and social studies than the state average. But the biggest thing that I think that jumps out of those pages is your post-secondary distinction that you got. It's very clear because in the English department, the state average is 45%. You guys are at 80%. In science and social studies, those are like 44 and 39%. You're in the mid-70s, up 35, 36 points. Additionally, when you look at your SAT scores and your ACT scores, SAT, you're 147 points higher than the state average, ACT 2.7 points higher. I mean, I think that's phenomenal. You're getting kids ready. When they leave Argyle High School, they're ready to go on to a four-year university. If they don't have the money or the means or the wherewithal to do that, they can go to a local junior college, they can get that 2 years associate's degree, or they can go right into the workforce and still be successful members of society, which I think ultimately is the goal that we should all have. The other area that you wanted me to talk about was technology and its uses and my knowledge about it. And I don't think that your point there was for me to talk for a minute or so about how I know how to use student management software or Edufori to disaggregate tax data and find weak SEs and things like that. I do know how to do those things, but I think what your question was more to how technology can be utilized to improve instruction. And I think that's the key. I think giving a teacher a computer and an inner right pad or a projector and telling them to go after it isn't really the way to go, because they're going to create some fancy PowerPoint and their dull, boring lesson that lacks engagement is still going to be dull and boring. It's just going to be on a PowerPoint. At the same time, if you hand a bunch of kids a laptops or Chromebooks, like you guys have a Chromebook initiative, and just say, hey, this is for you to use for education, yeah, they might look some things up on Wikipedia or Google every so often and give you an answer. But are they using that tool to improve their learning? And I think what has to happen is you got to have great teachers with great lesson designs that can utilize technology and have that technology available so that they can work together hand in glove and mesh to create a strong lesson. Yeah, there's a lot of great programs out there like virtual dissections and virtual field trips, or even using the camera to flip the classroom like you've done with this interview. But I think what has to happen is the teacher's got to have the knowledge and the understanding of how to do that, to push it into the students' hands, to use it as a tool, not just to play games and applications or search their social media, but to improve their instruction. And I think ultimately what you want to do is you want to get kids or students to collaborate more, to become more creative in what they're doing as far as their response to projects and design and lesson process and lesson outcome. You want to improve their communication, their ability to speak and convey their message out to the public, whether it be the teacher of that classroom, out in the general public, or just to other students in the classroom. And ultimately, you want to increase the rigor and elevate the critical thinking so that you can have those distinctions in post-secondary readiness. The final thing that you asked me to talk about was what I could bring that's unique to Argyle. And I think the biggest thing that I can bring to you is an understanding of how the high school is designed and developed and run. I've got this large school concept, 2,000 students, lots of experience, 9 years there, come up with some great programs that have helped improve instruction. We've got a late start program where we moved our school day back on Mondays by 30 minutes, which allows our teachers about 55 minutes to communicate and meet in a PLC. We've also was involved in creating an RTI grade recovery program where zeros weren't permitted. In that program, we were able to eliminate zeros and reduce our failure rate per class by 6 weeks, over 40% over the last 3 years that we've had that program. The final thing is a large program that we had called Homeroom. Homeroom's not a new concept, but it is with all these new technologies, new things that we've got to do with House Bill 5 and all these restrictions that we have TEA is always kind of burdening us with. We were able to find 30 minutes one time a week where we could meet with students, peer mentor them, give them those lessons that we've always loved to give, like on how not to text and drive, the six pillars of character, even pass back scores from PSATs if that's what needs to be done. But we've got a great program there. I think I could bring that to you. Those are obviously on top of things like, you know, hard work and dedication and teamwork and motivating staff and organizing things and keeping people on the same page to keep a high school moving forward. I think that those are some programs that I can really bring that would really help your campus out. Again, I appreciate your time listening to my presentation. I'm sorry I went over just a few minutes. Tough to get all that kind of in a 5-minute video. But I look forward to a phone call from you. Hope I get an opportunity to sit down face-to-face, discuss some of these things a little bit more in depth. I look forward to your phone call, and go Eagles!